Hey guys, this is Solly here. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create and edit a WordPress blog post, how to create categories, and how to create menus using these categories. I'm not going to go through the whole process of setting up your WordPress blog. I'm assuming you've already done that, and I've got a separate tutorial for that. Right, so let's get started. I'm going to first type in my WordPress blog address. Now, as you can see, my blog is empty. I've got no blog posts, I've got no menus, no categories, nothing in there. And to make any changes to my WordPress blog, the first thing I need to do is to log in to my WordPress dashboard. And the correct way to do that is to first type your WordPress blog address, then a forward slash, and then wp-admin. So that's your blog address forward slash wp-admin. I'm going to hit enter. Now that brings us to our login page. I'm going to type in my username, my password, and click on login. So that brings us to our WordPress dashboard. If you look at the left-hand side, you've got all these menu options where you can add posts, you can add pages, you can change the theme of your WordPress blog, and so on and so forth. So to start, let's first add a blog post into our WordPress blog. To do that, I'm going to go to the Posts menu and say Add New. So let's first start by giving a title to our WordPress blog post. I'm going to call this Digital Stories. I also need some text for my blog post. For now, I'm just going to put in some dummy text. So that's my text. Now you can format this text the way you would format a Microsoft Word document or any other text editor. So, for example, if I want to break this text into paragraphs, I'm going to just take my cursor and click and then hit enter. And that's created a paragraph. Right, I'm not going to make any other changes over here. I'm going to go ahead and publish this post. So I'm going to click on the publish button. Right, so that seems to be done. Now, let's go take a look at what our post looks like. And there it is. That's our first blog post. I've got my title and I've got all my dummy content in there. That looks fine. So let's go back to the dashboard and let's create another post. So to do that, I can either click on the Add New menu on the left-hand side or I can click on the Add New button on top. They're both the same. So I'm going to click on the Add New button. I'm going to type in that blog post title. And I'm also going to type some dummy text. I'm going to break that text, create a paragraph. Now, in this post, I'm going to also insert an image. Now, to do that, I'll have to go to the Add Media section and then click on that. As you can see, my media library is empty. I don't have any images or any content in here. So I'm going to go and click on the Select Files button. And I'm going to pick some random image from my computer, just about any image. I'm going to click on that one, say Open. And that brings that image into my media library. If you look at the right-hand side over here, you can change some of these options. So you can change the title of the image. I'm going to call it Night Sky. You can give it a caption. You can give some alt text and also a description for the image. I'm not going to change these for now. I'm just going to go ahead and insert it into my post. And there it is. Now, once you've inserted the image, you can continue editing it. I'm just gonna click on the image, and you can see there's a little pop-up menu over here. So you can align left, align center, align right. You can also edit the properties of this image. So I'm gonna click on that, and it opens up the section where we can add a caption, some alt text, realign the image, and we can also change the size of that image. So for example, it's right now it's 1920 into 1080 pixels. I'm going to reduce that. I'm going to make it a little smaller. So I'm going to pick a slightly smaller size. I'm going to click on that and update. See, that looks fine. I'm going to go ahead and publish that. And let's go back and take a look at what that looks like. I'm going to refresh my blog. And there it is, social media and images, our new blog post. That's my image there, and that's our previous post. Okay, let's go back, let's create a few more blog posts. I'm gonna click on add new. I'm gonna call this one sound and image. I'm gonna paste the same text in there. I'm gonna publish. I'm gonna create another blog post. I'm going to call this one cameras and tripods. Paste the same text there, publish. The reason I'm creating these blog posts is so that we can categorize them into different categories. I'm going to go ahead and create another blog post. And call this one random stuff. Put some text there, publish. Let's create one more blog post and then let's start categorizing them. I'm going to call this All About Images. Now for this blog post, I'm going to import a couple more images. So to do that, let's go back to our Add Media section. I'm going to click on that. Now as you can see, we've already got one image which we used in our previous blog post. I'm going to go to my Upload File section. I'm going to click on that. And let's upload a few more files. I'm going to click on the Select Files button. And I'm going to pick these three images. Now to select multiple images, I'm going to have to keep my Alt key pressed. In case it's a Windows keyboard, it's Alt. In case it's a Mac keyboard, it's the Command key. So I'm going to keep my Command key pressed and then click, click, and click. That's how you select multiple images. And then click on the Open button. So I've got these three images in my media library. As you can see, I've got the same options for these images. I can change the title, the caption, alt text, description, and so on and so forth. Now, if you want to select or unselect an image in your media library, all you have to do is click on that check mark there. If you want to select multiple images, you keep the Command key pressed. In case of a Mac keyboard, if it's a Windows keyboard, you press the Alt key pressed and then click, click, and click. I'm going to go ahead and say insert into post. So that looks fine. It looks like it's imported those three images and inserted them into my blog post. I'm going to go ahead and publish that. Let's go back to our blog and refresh and take a look at what our blog posts look like. Right, so there we have it. That's all the blog posts that we just created. That's the one with the images, the random stuff blog post, and all the other blog posts. Now, if you notice the last blog post, I don't like the way the images are different sizes. So I'm going to go back into my dashboard and I'm going to change the image sizes. So remember to do that, you'll have to click on the image, click on the edit button, and then change the size of the image. I'm going to reduce that size. Remember to update, scroll down, click, edit, change the size, update. I'm going to do that with the third image as well. Edit and update. I'm going to go ahead and update that post. Okay, now you've created all these blog posts. If you want to see a list of all the posts that you've created in your blog, then go back to the menu on the left-hand side and click on All Posts. That'll show you a list of all the posts you have in your blog. And that's the list of all the blog posts we just created. Now, you can make some changes to your posts from this section itself. So for example, I made a mistake while typing the title of this post. So I can just click on Quick Edit and then change that. And then say Update. And there it is. So you can make minor changes to the post properties from this section. It also shows the author of the post, what category has it been assigned, tags, and so on and so forth. Right, so now let's go ahead and create our categories. To do that, I'm going to go to the same menu on the left-hand side. I'm going to go to the posts menu on the left-hand side, and we've got something called categories over here. I'm going to click on categories. So now let's go and create some categories. So let's say that's my first category, sound and image. I'm going to click on the add new category button. Let's create a few more categories. Let's say digital stories. I'm going to click on add new. I'm going to create one more, random stuff, and then say add new. Right, so we've got three categories. Now, if you look at the right-hand side, there's something called count. And that's basically the blog posts that have been assigned to this particular category. So by default, all our blog posts have been assigned to the uncategorized section. And that's why the count is 6. We've got 6 blog posts and they've been all assigned to uncategorized. So once you've assigned a blog post to a category, it'll show up over here. It'll show you a count. And if you click on that, it'll take you to that section, to that category, and you can see all the blog posts in that category. Okay, so for example, if I click on the count over here, it shows all the blog posts in that category. So now that we've got our blog posts and we've got our categories, let's assign some of these blog posts to those categories. And to do that, I can do it from the All Posts section. So I've got all my posts here. All I have to do is click on Quick Edit and then assign it to any category that I want. So I'm going to assign this one to Sound and Image. I'm going to uncheck on Uncategorized and then say Update. As you can see now, that's changed to Sound and Image. I'm going to do that with the rest of the blog posts as well. I'm going to click on Quick Edit and then assign that to Random Stuff, uncheck Uncategorized, Update. Go to the next one, Quick Edit. I'm going to assign this to Digital Stories and Sound and Image. Every blog post can be assigned to multiple categories. So this blog post will appear in the Sound and Image category as well as the Digital Stories category. I'm going to uncheck uncategorized and update. Okay, I'm going to do the same here. I'm going to go and click on quick edit, assign that to sound and image, uncheck that, update. I'm going to assign this one to random stuff and digital stories, uncheck that. Update. Now you can also assign a blog post to a category by clicking on Edit. So if you look at the right hand side, you've got a section called Categories, and you notice you have all the categories that we just created. So I can now uncheck Uncategorized and then assign this blog post to, let's say, Digital Stories and Random Stuff. Once I've made the change, I'm going to go and say update. So now we've got our blog posts, we've got our categories, and we've assigned these blog posts to our categories. Let's see what change that makes I'm going to hit refresh. So we don't see a big visual change over here, except that it's added the category on the left hand side over here. So if you look at each blog post, that's my category. That's two categories there. That's my category. So that's the only change it has made. Let's go back to our dashboard. And now let's create menus and use these categories in those menus. If you look at our blog right now, I've got no menus. So any visitor to my blog has to basically keep scrolling until he finds the relevant content. So you need to have menus. It's good practice. So let's go back to our dashboard and let's create some menus. Now to create menus, I'm gonna have to go to the appearance section and then click on menus. I'm gonna click on that. Now, if you look at this section, you've got two main sections over here. One is called the edit menu section and the other one is called manage locations. In the edit menu section, it shows us there's one menu called primary. That's the menu name, primary. Now, our primary menu has three links: blog, about, and contact. So we have a menu, but it doesn't show up in our blog. Now, the reason why it doesn't show up is because it's not been assigned to any section. What we'll have to do is basically go to the manage location section. I'm going to click on that. And if you look at this section over here, you've got primary menu, but I've got no menu assigned to it. You've also got something called as social links menu, but I've got no menu assigned over there. That's the reason why we can't see any menu in our blog. Now, please note that this may not be the same for every blog. This will change depending on the theme that you've selected for your WordPress blog. So for my theme, I've got a primary menu and a social links menu, and I've got nothing assigned. So let's go ahead and assign a menu. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click and I'm going to assign the primary menu. And then I'm going to say save changes. Let's go back to our blog, hit refresh and see what that does. And that's it. That's our menu. So basically what we did, we assigned that menu to this section in our blog. So let's go back to the dashboard. Let's assign a social media menu and then say save changes. Let's go back to the blog, hit refresh. Let's see what that looks like. It's probably added something right at the bottom. Okay, there it is. That's our social links menu. The way this menu looks will change depending on the theme that you've selected for your WordPress blog. Right, so let's go back to the dashboard. Let's go to edit menus. Now you can change these links. So for example, if I want blog to be somewhere in between about and contact, I can do that. I can just click and drag. Remember, whatever changes you make over here, click on the save menu button. So now let's go ahead and let's create links to our categories. If you look at the left hand side, we've got a section called categories. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to click on view all. It shows us all the categories we have in our WordPress blog. Now I'm going to add these categories as menus. So I'm going to click, click, click and say add to menu. Right, so what it's done is it's taken these categories and created menu links. I'm going to save that menu. I'm going to go ahead and refresh my blog. And let's see what that does. So it's created these menu links using my categories. If I click on any of these links, it'll load that category and show me all the blog posts within that category. So for example, if I click on random stuff, it'll show me all the blog posts inside random stuff. So that's fine, except that I don't want my menus lined up like this. Imagine I add two more categories. What's going to happen over here? I've got no space left over here and it looks a little too crowded. So I want to change the way the menus are set. So let's go back to the WordPress dashboard. I want to make these three categories as a drop-down menu. And to do that, I'm just going to have to click and drag. Click and drag. You notice when I clicked and dragged my menu, it made it into a sub-item. So if I drag it back, that sub-item is gone there. Now it's become a main menu section. But if I click, it makes it a sub-item. I'm going to say save menu. Let's take a look at what that does. Let's go back to our blog and hit refresh. If you notice now, it's made those three categories into a drop-down menu. And that's exactly how I want it. So I can create any number of categories and then make them into menus, and it'll just keep adding them over here. So let's go back to our dashboard. Let's say I want to create another link in my navigation. I want to call it the home button. So to do that, I'm going to have to create a custom link. I'm going to type in my blog address. I'm going to call it home and then say add to menu. And there it is. And I want this one right up in the beginning. I'm going to click and drop it over there and then say save menu. Let's go back to our blog, refresh, and there it is. So basically, if I go to contact, it'll load my contact section. And if I want to go back to my home page, I just have to click on home. So you can create any number of links from the dashboard. I hope that helped you guys. If you've got any doubts, you want to clarify something, you can drop a message in the comment section or you can just email me and I'll reply as soon as I can. All right, thanks for watching, guys.